he is such a global figure. He appeals to everyone of us. Whether you don't like classical music, or you know classical music, or you don't really know about it, whether you are music educated or you are not musical educated, when you hear Chopin, you start to get connected. And that's the magic of Chopin. 1994, my first impression of Europe was in the beautiful summer day, we were preparing to go to Ettlingen for the Ettlingen Young International Pianist Competition. First time I feel, you know, the music and the landscape, the culture, are actually connecting. And that was the first major impression on me about Europe. It's truly the classical music birthplace. The Tchaikovsky competition for young musicians was actually the biggest competition for people under 16 years old. It was very difficult for me in the beginning, but then my father was telling me, maybe you should think about your mom, how much you miss her. And that worked really well. So I played with all my passion to want to hug my mom, want to live with my mom. After winning the Tchaikovsky Young Musician Competition, my career took off. I remember that concert was a very successful first round of my career, you know, to starting to build up a real solid professional career. We sent that video to Gary Graffman. He watched it and he said, it's time for you to move from China to America and to come to Curtis to study. And then right after I just turned 14 years old, I start to play the complete Chopin etudes in the Beijing Concert Hall again. But a lot of the etudes like the Winter Wind, it was quite new for me to learn after the competition. Chopin is not just exercise your fingers, it's more about exercising your heart, your mind, and a complete musicianship. So today, when I start playing it again, I'm not just focused on technical point, but I realize why I'm actually doing this interpretation. Over the years, we learned how to serve for the musical sense.